자, 여기가 바로 노팅엄 파운데이션 그리고 프리마스터 과정이 진행되는 유니버시티 오브 노팅엄 인터내셔널 컬리지입니다. 여기는 이제 사이언스 파크, 노팅엄 대학교에 있는 사이언스 파크에 위치해 있고요. 여기 이제 여기 들어가는 입구인데 보시면 정말 공원이 있어요. 여기 그리고 이 뒤쪽 저 반대편으로는 이제 다 노팅엄 대학교예요. 그래서 아마 여기 처음 오시는 분들은 여기 맞아? 막 이렇게 하실 수도 있을 것 같아서 제가 일부러 이 영상을 지금 찍고 있는 겁니다. 그래서 이쪽으로 이렇게 들어갑니다.
Main building reception. On here you'll be able to access different parts of the building. So I'll take you around and show you some of our classrooms and then at the end of it we'll conclude at the college's own reception where I'll introduce you to some of the staff that work at reception.
Yep.
Good. So we're going to start with the original space that we used when we got here as a college. And this original space is what we call the traditional classrooms, okay? And I'll speak to you about what makes them traditional. Okay. And then later on, I'll show you a different type of classroom, and I'll also speak to you about the difference. This is what you would call a traditional classroom, and it's traditional in the sense that everything is focused to the front of the room. And in this room, you've got an overhead projector, you've got desks of students, and typically, a tutor would be sitting at the front talking about what's going on here. Okay? The one thing that might make this room a little different from your typical classrooms is that we've got magic paint on the walls and that students are able to write on the walls and do calculations or whatever they may be studying in the class. One thing with our projector is that it is on Wi-Fi and students are able to connect to the projector and show their phones on the screen. And so if you're doing activities on your phone, we use the phone for learning here because this is a technology enhanced learning environment. And if you're doing that, so you can show your phone on the screen, and the teacher can also choose which phones to show, right? So it's a very connected college. So here we have a student space. In normal days, students would be able to sit here and relax, usually during their break times. Our classes run from 9 o'clock until 11, that's the first 2 hours, then 11 until 1, and between 1 and 2 is free time. And in that free time, some students will come here, eat the food that they've brought. Some students will go to university. So this is our main student hangout space. In here, we've got games. Soon enough, we'll have our PlayStation here. So students are able to come in between classes, hang out, chill out. We do a lot of events in this room. At the moment, it's all decorated for Black History Month. As you can see on the walls, we've got posters talking about some famous black people. You can see Lewis Hamilton for F1 on that wall, Nelson Mandela here. So it's celebrating Black History Month. We have an event every week to celebrate, and also we do competitions and things like that. So remember, you're here to learn, but you need some time to relax, and this is one of those spaces where students can relax. I showed you what we describe as a traditional classroom. So here now, I'm going to show you a different type of classroom. So in this classroom, we like to call it active learning space, okay? So active learning space means that the student is mostly responsible for the way that they are going to learn in that class. What we have here is 6 desks with clusters of 5 chairs, and students sit in a group. And on each desk, there's a TV screen, and that TV screen is controlled by the teacher from their laptop here. And on their laptop, they're able to send different messages to the screen. So I'm going to quickly send something to the screen so that you can see how it works. And students are also able to send things to the screen, which makes it a really interactive experience. So what you're looking at now is my screen. If I wanted to show you a video on YouTube, I could easily do that and it will start playing. Now, the beauty of this is because we're using different applications to learn, the screens allow for students to take ownership of their learning. We follow a very simple philosophy for learning here. We say to students, before you come to class, here are some materials on our virtual learning environment. We would like you to discover what you're going to learn. So by discover means you're preparing before you come to class. So you go on the virtual learning environment, which we call VLE, and you'll see what you're doing tomorrow. You read it, you try to understand it, and then when you come to class, we do the next part of this philosophy that we use. It's called the develop phase, right? So during the develop phase, you're now working with your teacher and fellow students to develop the knowledge that you've learned from your discover when you were reading before you came to class. In that develop session, the teacher will ask you questions, you will ask questions yourself, and then there'll be some exercise to do in class which you share on these screens while you're learning. After that, when you finish, we have to do the do phase of the philosophy, okay? In the do phase, you may have a test, you may have some homework, and this is now to show that you have learned and understood what you were supposed to learn. Three things. We do discover, develop, do, okay? This is all part of active learning, and the student is at the center of that learning. So you have to prepare for class. When you get to class, you have to participate. And then when you finish, you have to demonstrate that you were able to understand. However, don't worry if you don't quite get it, because the teachers will help you, okay? The teachers are here to support you. Even though this is active learning, putting a lot of the responsibility on the students to learn, the teacher is always present, okay? The teacher is able to walk around the room, ask you if you understand, ask you if you have any problems, and they support you to learn. This is a great way of learning. A lot of students are not used to this type of learning, but this is an important part of learning in the UK, because here we want to develop independent learners, okay? Independent learners, when you go to university, you'll do a lot of work yourself, okay? So independent learning is an important part of learning in the UK, and it starts being developed here. So in this space is much like upstairs, all active learning spaces. And this is a huddle room, and usually we use them for one-to-one sessions with the teacher. Students can book to use it if they're here to study. It's a accommodation for up to 5 people, no more than that. So we can do very small classes, but the rooms are essentially the same. TVs on all desks. Students do remember that philosophy. Develop, discover, do. And all we're trying to do is to encourage students to become independent learners, okay? Good. So here now is the main reception of the college. So when you walk in, you will see there's always a smiling face to welcome you here. And you can see a lot of things talking about Nottingham, talking about Kaplan, and also spaces for students to hang out while they're waiting for class or waiting to see someone in the college. There are also offices down here where we have the head of college services, the college director is down here. Down that way, the offices for teachers, and there are other offices for teachers around the building as well.
노팅엄 약대가 이제 여러분 잘 아시다시피 랭킹도 굉장히 좋고 빠뜨릴 것이 하나 없잖아요. 그러니까 영국 약대를 오시는 분들은 꼭 노팅엄 약대를 기억을 해주셨으면 좋겠고 참고로 여기 약대 입학 기준도 굉장히 유연합니다. 우리나라 내신으로는 6등급, 검정고시로는 80점 이상, 그리고 특성화고등학교도 학생이 어떤 공부를 했는가에 따라서 입학 허가가 날 수도 있으니까 지레 겁먹지 말고 그러니까 여기 세계에서 다섯 번째로 좋은 거고 약학으로는 사실은 영국 1등인데 QS 랭킹에서 봤을 때 너무 좋은 학교니까 나 못 가는 거 아니야 이렇게 지레 겁먹어서 포기하지 마시고 저희 공식 지원처인 영국약닷컴으로 언제든 문의 주시면 저희가 최선을 다해서 도와드리도록 하겠습니다.